This next video is going to show you how to complete the third quadrant in Cal State Apply. To start, go ahead and select the third quadrant, also known as Supporting Information. When we click on this option, you should only see either one or two sections listed. You will see either two sections that say Associate Degree for Transfer, ADT, and Educational Opportunity Program, EOP, or you will only see one section, which will say Educational Opportunity Program, EOP. The reason I'm seeing more sections is because I already started the EOP application, but you will not see that getting into it for the first time. If you see Associate Degree for Transfer, ADT, as a section available, this is because in your extended profile, you answered that you would be receiving an Associate Degree for Transfer. If you did not select that option, then you will not see the ADT section listed, and you will only see EOP. I'm going to go ahead and select the ADT section to see what questions it's going to ask me. When I'm in the section, I can see that the first two fields are already populated from my profile. The third field does need to be completed by me, and I need to list my Citrus College student ID number, or if I'm receiving my ADT from another community college, I need to list that community college's student ID number. The fourth field, California Community College ID, I can leave blank. The fifth field is asking for completed or anticipated degree date. This is very important. Please be sure to click on the calendar to let them know when you are going to be receiving the ADT. If you are earning your ADT in fall 2020, please report December 2020 as your date of completion. If you are earning your ADT in spring 2021, please report June 2021 as your date of completion. Once you're finished, go ahead and click on Save and Continue. Now it's going to lead me into the application for the EOP program, if I wish to do so. If I want to find out more about EOP, there is a very helpful link here that I encourage you to visit. This is to find out more information about EOP, what you need to do to be eligible, and when specific deadlines are for the application. Let's go ahead and click on that site. In this site, if you scroll down, you'll see two buttons. Let's go ahead and click on the first one to read the frequently asked questions. In here, you'll find out very important and useful information about EOP. For example, what is the function of EOP? What type of student does EOP look for? What services are provided by EOP, who is eligible, and more. Definitely review this if you have questions about EOP. If we click on Start the Process, we're going to receive information on EOP materials. For example, two names and email addresses must be entered in this EOP application as letters of recommendation. So you will be expected to plug in two recommenders along with their email addresses, as they will be required to submit a recommendation for you. You'll also need to complete an autobiographical portion for EOP sections. The general deadlines to submit the EOP portion of your Cal State Apply application are as follows: for fall, January 15th of that year, and for spring, August 31st of the year prior. If we click on this link, EOP Admission by Term, we can find out more detailed information about specific deadlines. If we look at the first column, it's letting us know which campus we're referring to. Let's skip the second and the third, as these are regarding freshman applicants. We're instead going to focus on the fourth and the fifth columns regarding transfer applicants. This is going to let us know specific deadlines for fall 2020. This is my example because I'm applying for fall 2020 admission, and it's letting me know the deadline for the EOP application, as well as the deadline for specific documents. This would include your recommendation deadline from your recommenders. So when you get to that section where you're filling in the information for your recommender, it will ask you to send your recommender a specific deadline. This is where you're going to find that information. Let's go ahead and go back to the application. The first question is asking whether or not you're currently enrolled in an EOPNS program at your community college. I said no, but if you are, you need to select yes, and you need to let them know which community college you are part of for EOPNS. Do you wish to apply for EOP at the Cal State? If you select yes, the questions will expand and you'll be asked more. If you select yes, I will return to a later time to complete these EOP questions. Then you will be able to continue and you can submit your application, but you will need to go back in and answer the autobiographical questions as well as the recommendation names and emails. If I select no, I will see the same thing. It will allow me to save and continue my application. Let's go ahead and select yes so we can see the questions. First one, if you attended a CSU, were you enrolled in an EOP program? I selected not applicable because I have not been to a Cal State in the past, nor was I part of an EOP program at a specific Cal State. If I select yes, they just want to know which Cal State campus I attended and was part of the EOP program at. The next questions are regarding specific programs in high school and beyond that you may have been a part of that were educational programs such as AVID and Upward Bound. The next section is asking about family information. Please answer accordingly. Where do you plan to live while attending college? How many brothers and sisters are currently attending a K-12 school? How many brothers and sisters are currently attending college? How many brothers and sisters received a bachelor's degree? What languages are spoken in your home? The next three questions are asking about whether your family has received any income from public assistance programs, whether or not your family has participated in publicly funded programs, and whether or not any children in your family work primarily to contribute to household expenses. If I answer this third question as yes, it will want more information about this question. You will need to expand on your answer. Please read this important reminder regarding the deadline to submit your autobiographical questions and your recommender information if you choose to come back later to complete the EOP application after submitting. It gives you more details here about that, so please read this important reminder. I'm going to click on Save and Continue. The next section is asking again, do I wish to continue with the EOP application or do I want to return later to complete these EOP questions? I want to keep going, so I'm going to select yes. The next questions are regarding my parent or guardian information. If this is not applicable because I don't have any information to report, then I can select does not apply or I can enter that into the field. As an example, I just put in one parent. So here it's asking for the name in the first field. Second field is asking for the occupation of this parent. And the third field is asking for occupation 10 years ago. Do I have any information to report for a second parent or guardian? I selected no, but if you select yes, it will ask you the same questions for parent or guardian number two. The next part is asking about financial status of your household. This is going to be regarding the year that you're submitting the application. So because I'm applying for fall 2020, it's asking about my parent or guardian income information for the year 2020. It's going to ask for parent number one and for parent number two, but parent number two is optional. It also wants to know the total size of my parent or guardian's household, and it wants to know whether or not I'm independent of parental support. These questions are important and they are mandatory to complete even if you are independent. As it says up here in the first statement, the following information is used to determine history of low income eligibility for EOP, and all applicants must complete this section. As a reminder, be sure that you're completing your FAFSA or your California Dream Act application. Now we're getting into the biographical questions. Again, it's asking, do I want to continue or do I want to come back? I want to continue, so I selected yes. And these are my biographical questions. Please read each one carefully and answer it in as much detail as possible. The more information you provide, the better. Now it's going into the EOP recommendations. I already plugged in my recommendation, so I'm seeing that the bar is fully covered and there's a check mark for each one. But the way that you're going to see it when you're filling in recommendation information is you're going to see a recommendation request. It will ask you for the name, email, and EOP deadline. Remember to check that chart for the deadline. And also you will need to leave a personal message, a brief message for your recommender. Before filling this out, it is very important that you contact this recommender and that you ask them whether or not you can list them as a recommender. Please give them a heads up that you would like to use them as a recommender and that they will be asked personal questions about you. They may need more information from you in order to answer these questions about you. So please be sure to contact them. It will ask whether or not you waive the right of access to this recommendation. There's no right or wrong way to answer this question. I just selected no. Then it's going to ask for permission to contact recommender and permission for schools to contact recommender. So I already filled out this portion and I already have my two recommenders listed and now I'm ready to move forward. If I go to my application, I can see that I am now done with the third quadrant, supporting information. Please check out our next video regarding completion of the fourth quadrant, program materials. Thank you.